Hi, I'm AJ, and thanks for taking your time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you're really gonna like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Recently, I was asked how I was able to remember all of the passwords for all of the accounts that I have. If you're a part of the Mobile Money Nation, you know that I do a lot of reviews of different investing platforms and checking accounts and savings accounts. And for many of these platforms, I'd say the majority of them, I actually created accounts with them. So I use them to either test it out or just to see if it's something that I may be interested in using for the long term. And so with creating those accounts, you have to create usernames, you have to connect your email address, or you have to choose a new email address if you want to separate them from different types of categories of accounts. You know, maybe you don't want to use the same email address that you use for your bank account, that you use for your investment account, that you use for social media and things of that nature. And so every time you have a password, whether it's your direct email with Gmail or Yahoo or whoever you use, or your individual investment accounts, your health savings account, literally every account that you could possibly have on a website or within an application, you have to create a password for those applications and websites. And for some of us, and I'd even say for most of us, especially once those different accounts start to add up, that's a lot of passwords that you have to remember. And not only that, you don't want to make the password so easy, like making your password actually be password. And anybody can guess that. And especially there are people out there who they spend their time and their day trying to get into people's accounts. Some of your information is being bought and sold on different dark web websites. After it's been stolen from some other website and now they have all the credentials, they have your email address, they have passwords that you've used on different sites, and that's being sold. So trying to remember those passwords, make them hard enough for other people not to be able to guess it, but also easy enough for you to remember, those can add up and you usually end up using the same password for multiple accounts. So in order to avoid that, I started using a password manager. And the password manager that I personally use is called LastPass. Now with LastPass, once you create an account with them, you literally only have to remember one password, and that's the password to get into LastPass. Because once you create that account, you can connect all of your other accounts. So you can add your email, like your Gmail login, you can add your banking and investment account login, savings accounts, checking accounts, whatever type of login that you have where you need to remember a password, you can save it within this service. You can download the app on your Android or your iOS device, and you can also use the an extension that's available via Chrome, the Brave browser, Safari. Most of the browsers out there, you can download it as an extension. And so on your phone, or if you're on a desktop and you're using the extension on your web browser, once you log into LastPass, you now have access to log into every account that you've saved within LastPass, just at a click of a button. And now since you have those passwords saved in a safe place, you know, not saved on a napkin or on a notepad on your desk or on a little sticky note on your computer screen, you know, somewhere where someone else could access it if they just happen to walk by, whatever the case may be, those aren't very safe places to save your password. And now that you have a safe place that you can save those passwords, you don't actually have to remember these passwords, because LastPass will actually copy and paste your username and your password into the applications that you use on your mobile devices or into the website if you're using your desktop computer to access whatever website that you're logging into. And so you literally never have to remember your password. The only password you do need to remember is the password to LastPass. And now because you don't have to remember your password, you can make much longer and more complex passwords. In fact, they actually have an option within LastPass where it can create a random password and you can choose the specific length of characters, whether it's 8, 10, 16, or maybe a longer number. And then you can even add the specifics of what you will need for a specific website. So on some websites, you need letters, numbers, capital letters, and also special characters. And you can add that in the option for when you're creating a, or when you're generating a new password, that it has all of that criteria, plus the length that you need for that specific website or that specific application. And so you can literally have just a random string of letters and characters, capital letters, special characters, and you never have to remember it because it's saved within LastPass or whatever password manager you decide to use. LastPass just happens to be the one that I use and that works great for me. And so with the LastPass premium account, it's just $3 a month. $36 per year if you pay it annually. And this will allow you to store an unlimited number of passwords with that premium access. And they also have options for multiple users. So if you have family and you want them all to use LastPass so they can save their passwords, or maybe you want to save passwords for, you know, your son or your daughter, or maybe you have a parent, an older parent that, you know, has a bad memory, or yourself if you have a bad memory, your wife, your husband, or if you have a business, you can have the enterprise option where you can have multiple users. Whatever the case may be, you can use LastPass, and it's a great application. I use it on all of my devices on desktop. I have Android and iOS devices, and it works great. So for any of you out there who have trouble remembering your passwords, you know, you want to stop leaving them on sticky notes and napkins on your desk, make sure you check out LastPass. There's a link in the description down below, also in the comments, so you can check that out. If you do have any additional questions about LastPass, or if you personally use LastPass, or maybe a different password manager, make sure you leave a note in a comment so we can talk about it. And anything that I didn't address within this video, I'll try to answer them within the comments below. All right, thanks for watching this video. Thanks for being a part of the Mobile Money Nation. And if you're not a part of the Mobile Money Nation, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. All right, thanks for watching. You guys have a great day.